Hi everyone, it's Ollie Ralph here. It's been a beautiful sunny day today. The sun is just about to go down, so I thought I'd better get this quick video done before it ever got done at all. I've been trying to do it for the last couple of weeks, but didn't quite get around to it. Mainly probably because my brain wasn't quite in sync with my mouth, and it seems to be not that quite okay today as well. But it seems that some of you guys don't really care about bloopers in videos, so I don't think why I should either. So anyway, let's go for the one take. Now, firstly, I want to say a big thanks to all you guys out there for making some truly inspirational videos. I didn't really know what to expect when Alex Karras asked me to join his group Hurricane of Gratitude, but I'm quite thankful that he actually did appear on the scene, and I'm glad that I actually made the right decision to come and join your group. Your videos have been inspirational. I've always had my yin and yang in a good sync, but the positive energy coming out of your videos have been a big influence on helping me start my day on an even higher note than I would normally do. So thank you very much. Now, as for gratitude, there has to be, I suppose, memories right now, memories of my parents. Mainly because those that don't know me, my mother died at the end of July in what had been closing the door on a chapter of 12 years of back-to-back caring for both my parents. Firstly, my father, who had Alzheimer's disease, terrible disease. I really would like to thank the men and women who dedicate their life to pushing the frontiers of science in the help of developing drugs to help ease the suffering of people who have it. And in my father's case, that was about 3 years. He was able to have some more normality in his life before the disease finally took control of his bodily organs. Secondly, I'd like to thank the paramedics for that fateful night that they managed to bring my mother back from the dead in the ambulance after she had a massive heart attack, and she had another 16 months of life on this planet. And there wasn't a day that wasn't enjoyed to the max, probably. Yeah, so there's happy memories on there, but looking back at them, I mean, I was there's never a dull day that didn't have something new or something exciting happening in it, so I'm being truly grateful for being able to share that in their experiences, I suppose. I never quite envisaged that my life would involve take a tangent into caring. I mean, I used to have a great job career up in working in London in the city as a designer, but suddenly found myself one day caring for the parents, and I can't never look back, and probably the most beautiful, wonderful thing that had ever happened in my life, as it were, up until that point. So I'm really thankful and grateful that I actually got the opportunity to care for them. I mean, most people don't really get the opportunity to do that. So that's been a wonderful memory. So that's as far as the parental memories are concerned. But with so many, I've yet to sort and sift all those mental processes in which I want to store in the memory banks, and which I'll just look back and laugh. But some wonderful times. Anyway, finally, as Christmas is coming up, I hope all you guys are looking forward to spending time with your family. Don't feel sorry for me, but I will have my, be a quieter one, a bit tougher one than normal, but I survive, made of strong stuff, got a lot of character, as they say. And I look forward to having some friends around, so I shan't be home alone. And as for New Year's, I've yet to decide. I might go over to Munich, or go over to the mountains. That's nice. Fresh views over there, and I look forward to 2009. It's been a wonderful, beautiful year. So you guys will have a great Christmas and a great New Year's, and if 2008 has been tough for you, been caring like I have, or if life hasn't been too good for you, I sincerely hope that 2009 is a beautiful year for you too. So take care, God bless, and enjoy a wonderful Christmas.